Hey, what is up guys? Guitar Rock here. Welcome back to another Blue Archive video. Now, a bunch of unexpected things happened today. If you guys check out the social media for Blue Archive, Nexon basically just posted three new things. Number one, Shizuko. We're gonna have this new character coming into Blue Archive. Alright, she is to be expected because she's a 2-star. So yesterday I did mention about Izuna. If you guys haven't checked that video out, a 3-star banner. So Shizuko and Izuna are both going to share the same banner. But not only that, we're going to have a new Total Assault, Shiro and Kuro coming soon as well. Now this caught me by surprise, because I don't know if you guys follow the JP, but if you follow the order of raids in JP, supposedly after Bina, we're supposed to have something called Cheesed, right? Which is another yellow raids. But it seems like, you know, in global, they're skipping that out, putting Shiro and Kuro, so that just changes everything. Because this raid, Mystic characters are going to have the advantage. As you can see, defense type special armor. So if you have blue characters, Haruna, Chisei, yo, those characters are gonna be so good. And I think Nexon really wants you to pull on this banner, right? With Shizuko and Izuna in it. And also, not to mention, alright, we're gonna have a new event, Cherry Blossom Festival Commotion. As you can see, 29th of November. Man, so many things happening next week. So we're gonna have a new event, we're gonna have a new raids, we're gonna have a new banner. So let's talk about it right now. Alright, first things first, we're gonna talk about Shizuko. Just to give you guys a context and idea of how strong she is. Now Shizuko is a special character, alright? So not to be confused with, you know, someone that's in front. She's someone that stays at the back, constantly supporting your team from the back. Alright, she uses a shotgun. As you can see, she's a mystic against special armor, blue-blue. Alright, blue offensive, blue defensive. Going to the stats, alright, so she has about 2k HP. Stats are not super important for special. I mean, they are important in a certain way, but not extremely important. So let's talk about skills, where the thing comes in. So 3 costs, which is very good. I like 3 costs skill. It enables you to cycle around quicker. I'm looking at Hina, 7 costs. Ugh. What she does is she summons a structure with 46% of HP. This is at max level, by the way, level 5. Increase her ally's accuracy within a round shape area by 21.3% for 30 seconds. As you can see, summon structure and increase ally's accuracy. So she's more designed to buff accuracy. I'm not sure how viable is this in PvP. If it is, it might be able to counter Tsubaki, which is like the cancer of, you know, PvP basically. She avoids everything. She has very high evasion, in case you guys are wondering. Alright, look at a normal skill. Basically, every 25 seconds, she deals a percentage of damage, very high percentage of damage against a single enemy. Reduces its attack by 18.3%. This is actually pretty good against raid bosses. If you think about it, if you're struggling with survivability, having this debuff to basically reduce bosses' enemy bosses' attack by a certain percentage definitely helps for sure. Let's look at the passive skill. Increase her accuracy by 26.6%. And the last sub skill, my personal favorite. And this is why I think if you want to pull for her, it's going to be this skill right here. She increased allies' crit rate by 17%. Alright, that is a lot. Increasing crit rate, if you have alongside with Hibiki, which also increased crit damage if I remember correctly, these two are beast, alright, you have increased crit rate, you have increased crit damage, best combo ever. But you're gonna be lacking the healer. But I do think that this crit rate can be super beneficial for sure. Having crit rate, you know, helps a lot, especially early on, because your, what is that, your equipments, most of your gears are not T4 yet. Once you go to T4, they tend to give more crit, right, for your damage dealers. So having this boost, 17% or 15%, whatever, is just going to be extremely beneficial. Now, I strongly believe Shizuko will be sharing banner with Izuna. I don't think they're going to split it up. But here's what I think, right? In yesterday's video, I did say that you might not want to pull for Izuna if you already have a lot of Mystic characters. But now that we know that the Shiro Kuro raid is coming, things might change, you know? Things might change because Shiro Kuro, this boss, like I mentioned, defense is special armor. So this boss, they are both special armor. But this raid, I believe, is no longer a beta. So you can basically borrow one members from your, you know, from your guildmates to be able to help you out. So this is how they look like. I do think that if you don't pull for this banner, right, you're gonna lack a bunch of Mystic characters. You might not be able to form 2 teams even. If, like, depending on how hard you want to go. If you're trying to beat very hard, for example, you know, definitely that's going to be a big struggle. if you're trying to beat very hard or hardcore, unless you're okay with sticking with, you know, like maybe normal. But in most cases, I'm guessing if you're trying to be, you know, in the top 10,000, which I believe most players should strive to get that free pyroxenes, right? Ideally, pulling is gonna give you an advantage. I don't know, man. Now that there's two mystic characters together in the same banner, I'm really tempted to pull myself, because especially someone like me who do not own a Haruna myself, I feel like either having Shizuko, Izuna is gonna be so beneficial for sure. What do you guys think, right? Also, the first event, let's talk about it for a short while. Cherry Blossom Festival. Alright, so they did make this huge announcement, Cherry Blossom Festival, 29th of November. But let's talk about this, you know, because this is something that I think most players need to be aware of. First things first, if you pull for the characters, they will be able to boost the currency that you get for the event. In case you guys are not familiar with how the event works, basically there'll be a couple of stages. Let me see if I can show it to you. Yeah, so there'll be some stages right here, as you can see, some stories, some quests. You can do this, you can sweep through this. So you'll be earning these currencies, alright, event currency. And there's not just one currency. There's apparently a few different ones, alright? Some character will give boost to certain currency drops, so you have to keep that in mind depending on what you're trying to obtain from the shop, and then you will be able to exchange it from the shop depending on what you want. So the bonus drop, as you can see, Chisei, Shizuko right here, they give bonus to this panda looking cookie thing, and then Izuna give bonus to the other one, Tsubaki and Pina. So these are the 5 characters that apparently have the boost, so basically 4 different event currency for you to farm for. Yeah, so it's just like any other gacha games event stages. You just farm the event, get the event currency, buy stuff from the shop, and try to empty the shop if you can, because it's probably the best return in terms of your stamina to event currency ratio. And yeah, most likely you'll be farming the last stage, just sweeping through that constantly. So yeah, now that we know this information, right? So we know that Shizuko, Izuna, most likely they'll be in the same banner. So I'm not sure what would the other banner be, you know? So this doesn't answer the question of, we are supposed to have 2 banners, ideally. So right now, as you can see, Mashiro and Aru. So assuming Izuna and Shizuko, assuming that they are replacing this Mashiro's banner, so who will be replacing Aru's banner? Some players have speculated that maybe Iori banner will come. If it's an Iori banner, I already have her, so I don't really need her that much, but hey, Iori is something that I believe every account should have, and that should be a priority to reroll. Again, we'll see how it goes. Just wait for a couple of days before Nexon posts something else on their Twitter page. I'm excited for that. Are you guys excited? Let me know in the comment section below. As always, if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, give this video a like, and I'll see you guys in the next one. I'm hype. I'll be pulling for the banner. Stay tuned!